Welcome, beloved. The Lord took me to hell for 351 days, and he took me to heaven for 40 days. On that day in prayer, when I fell for the first time in ecstasy, I was breathing, for I was not dead. They try hard to wake me up, but it was not possible, since I was working with pastors. They understood that the Lord was working with me, and whenever I fell into unconsciousness, these men of God were keeping my body in a private room. Welcome, brothers and sisters. I'm Pastor Aston Adan, from the Church of Sacred Chapel in Congo. Brother, no one preached the gospel to me. I was in the bar with my friend drinking alcohol when suddenly I heard the voice of God calling me. I was stunned. I said, I am not a Christian, but why is this God interested in me? I resisted the voice of God, and I said, I am not serving any God. But it was on that day that things changed completely. I gave my life to Christ. I was ordained by a man of God who trained me in the things of God. It is in that church that I served God. It is the Lord who commissioned me to render the testimony of things I saw, that I'm going to talk about. Actually, this encounter began one day while I was praying at night. As I kept praying, I felt a light. When I wanted to check who opened the bulb that I turned off not long ago, it is then I saw a light that was intense. It was 100 times greater than the sun. I could not watch this light and I fell on the ground into coma. This experience was not a death experience, for I was breathing. It was ecstasy, for I was raptured in the spirit and I left my body. As I collapsed on the ground, immediately I heard a voice in the middle of the light that called me by my name and said, Aston, my son, you have been chosen by God to be witness of things you are about to see. You will tell the world about secret that I will show you, and you will tell them that hell is real. Whoever will refuse to follow my way will fall in that horrendous place. I was in coma, but when I stood up from the floor, I saw that I was standing. However, my body was still laying on the floor. I was wondering what was happening to me. I became unable to touch physical things. I mean, I could not even touch my body, for there is no bond between the living and the dead. I was troubled, for whenever I tried to touch things, my hand was going through material and physical things. The people that were sleeping in my room could not see my spirit. When I tried to open the door, I saw that my body went through the steel door, and I wonder, in fact, I had all my senses, my intellect, my memory and my will, yet I could not touch anything. I was really troubled by all these phenomena, and I began to run around the neighborhood, and I was shouting for help. I went to my pastor place and I tried to talk to him, but he could not see and hear me. I went to my brothers, but they could not see me. I went in the street shouting, my neighbor, I'm Prophet Adan, come to see what is happening to me, but no one could hear me. Whenever I saw the living in the street, I tried to tell them about what was happening to me, for I was really troubled and restless. However, no one could hear me, for I was in another dimension. I kept shouting to people to come and see what was happening to me. As I was moving in the street, I began to realize that I was moving in a great speed, in comparison to the people who were alive. It was when I saw a man going through me that I began to come to the realization that I was dead. Brother, I saw that this man was in the same situation with me. He was troubled and in despair, and he was crying, talking to himself and asking, why have you people buried my body? I am alive. The man was crying bitterly. I continued to move around the city, and I began to see more people who were running around crying like me. They were all complaining that their family had buried their body. Brother, these people that I saw in the street were actually the dead. They were wandering spirit, for they were dead and their souls were wandering the earth. I was also a wandering spirit like them. I realized that I was in the world of the dead like these wandering spirit. It was when I reached the 18th street of the National Boulevard of the city, that I met a late Christian singer who was notorious in the country. This servant of God was known and popular. When I met Brother Charles Mwambaya, I saw that he was dressed in short and his shirt was torn. When I saw him, I was stunned because he was a popular singer, yet I saw that he was crying and saying, why have these people buried my body? I am alive. In fact, this singer was dead and he became a wandering spirit moving around the earth. Like all the dead that I was encountering in the street, I tried to tell him to stop so that we can talk, but he was so troubled he went away in confusion. Then I got around a popular church in the city. This church was not of God, for I saw demons in this church trying to capture my soul. Quickly I ran away from them in fear. As I continued to move in the city, I found myself in another borough of the capital, where I saw a group of people walking. They were naked. When I looked again, I saw that these people that were naked had horn on their head. There was a demon leading these witches. He was dressed in black. I saw that the demon that was the leader of these wizards was carrying a pot containing human blood. It was evident that I was actually in the spirit world, seeing what normal men cannot see. I saw that these naked wizards were dragging a man that was tied all over the body. This captive was also bound on the neck with a chain like a dog. This captive soul was dragged like a dog in the street, and he was moving in four leg. I heard him saying, "Oh my wife, you who are a Christian, rise up and pray for me, your husband. These people have captured my soul and they are taking my soul to destruction. Please my wife, I don't go to church like you, but please wake up and pray for me. I beg you, mother of my children, bad things are happening to me." These wizards replied to this captive, "Keep quiet and shut up, your wife is not coming." As these horned people were dragging this man, I told them, "Now you gonna stop this. What are you doing to this man? You got to release this captive." Quickly their leader, who also had horns, looked at me, and he looked at these wizards and said to his servants, "Let ignore him, we must move on." This demon and the witches ignore me and they move on dragging this captive with them. As they move forward, I decided to follow them. I was telling them, "You gonna release this man." We traveled to a place that was like a compound. In the end, I saw these demons hanging this man on a wood. They butchered his body and they share his flesh, and I saw them consuming his flesh, and they devour his all body. When I saw this horrendous scene, I feared, and I ran away for fear of being devoured by these demon. As I was moving, I saw people doing satanic and diabolic ritual in the middle of the boulevard, in churches, in the public bin, on the top of the tree. Some people were doing incantation. Souls of the dead were wandering here and there. I ran away and ended up in the general hospital. When I got inside the hospital, I saw two kind of people. I mean, I saw the living and the dead moving in the hospital. I saw physical being and spiritual being. When I got in the intensive care, I saw a doctor telling a group of nurse, "Our patient is dead." When the doctor spoke that way, I saw the dead patient sitting on the bed beside his body, and this woman was telling the doctor, "I am here sitting on the bed. Why are you saying that I am dead? Can't you see me?" As this patient was trying to talk to these nurse, I said to the doctor, "You are making a mistake. She is not dead, she is alive. Can't you see him?" Then I said to the young woman, "Tell them that you are alive, you are not dead." The young woman told me, "I have been telling them that I am alive. I think they are ignoring me and they don't want to hear me." Then I saw the doctor informing his family that he was dead, and the family began to cry. I tried to tell this family that their daughter is not dead, but they could not hear me. The woman began to talk to her family to tell them that she was alive, but they could not hear her. Finally, this young woman told me, "We are no longer in the world of the living anymore. We are in the afterlife. We have to go." This woman held my hand, led me to a morgue of the hospital, where I saw many people who had their hand on their cheek reflecting, and they seemed to be sad. We asked one of them, "Why are you sitting here very sad?" He said, "I had an accident and I was brought here in this hospital, but the doctor declared me dead. I told my family that I was not dead, but they ignored me, and they went on to bury my body. Since I have no place to go, I dwell here." The second man told us, "I was sick and I was brought here and I died. That is why I am here." Beloved, I want to tell you that the spiritual world is real and the physical world is just a veil hiding the realities of the unseen world. There is a physical world and there is a spiritual world populated with spirit being. I saw all these souls in the mortuary and they were complaining that their body were buried and they were stuck here, and they are waiting for their time. When I was about to leave this hospital, I wanted to open the door. Quickly I saw that my hand went through the door and I crossed the door. When I wanted to walk the street, I saw that I was crossing and penetrating walls of houses. I was able to pass through the walls of houses, and I saw people sitting and sleeping in their houses. I was effectively a spirit without body crossing walls of many houses. I saw whatever was happening inside people's house, but no one could see me. I was moving in great speed. And then I found myself around our local cemetery. When I got to this cemetery, I saw a group of people coming out of the cemetery, yet it was late in the night. I saw that these people had spiritual body, for there are physical body and immaterial body. These people that were coming out of the cemetery were not ordinary human. I was watching when I saw a man that sat on a chair at the gate of the cemetery, with a book that seems like a registration book on his table. I saw that these entity that were coming out of the cemetery stood in the queue before this man in order to sign in his registration book before leaving the cemetery. These demons of the cemetery were about to come out in order to operate in the physical world. Beforehand they had to register their name in the book before leaving the cemetery. When the first entity signed in the book, I saw him coming out of the cemetery to the middle of the street. I was watching this spirit. I saw that he took the sand from the ground and he splashed the sand in the air. Quickly I saw this demon entering inside the sand and turning to a physical man. I saw that this demon was dressed in human body thanks to the sand he had splashed in the air, and he had become a human, for he now had an appearance of a human. The second entity that came out of the cemetery did the same process of splashing the sand in the air, and he also became a physical human being. However, I saw that this entity had become a very beautiful woman with a lot of hair. She was wearing tight clothes and holding a bag like an earthly woman. I saw this woman that was a demon walking the street in the night, when suddenly a driver that was passing stopped his car in order to make advance to her, not knowing that she was a demon, not a human being. In the meantime, these demons kept coming out of the cemetery and they were taking human shape and becoming physical. I saw one of this entity leaving the cemetery with a photo of a dead man that he took from a grave. I saw this demon entering the photo of the dead person. Immediately he took the appearance of the person in the photo and he was exactly like the man in the photo. I was scared by this terrible phenomena. In the meantime, many more demons were coming out of the cemetery to operate in our world, and I decided to run away. After moving away from this place, I arrived in another borough of the capital. Though it was late night, to my surprise, I saw that there was a market with a lot of people buying and selling. I said to myself, there is never a market in this place during the day and in the physical world, and where are all these people coming from? Brother, this was a huge market full of people. I decided to leave. When I was leaving this market of witches and evil spirit, I saw a group of people coming towards the market. They had cotton on their ears and their nose. I saw that they were removing these cotton from their noses and ears, and they were happy to join the market. I was in wonder and I continued to run. I was crying and saying, what is happening to me? I ran all the night all over the city. I saw celebrity and popular people who are already dead. Their souls were wandering the city. These people were no longer physical, for their body were already buried, but they had their senses, their memory and reason just like me. After running all over the city, I was so tired that I prayed. I said, Lord, if only I ever serve you, please save me. When I did this prayer, quickly a light came down from heaven, and I heard a voice inside this light that came to me. The voice told me, my son, fear not, for you are chosen by God to be witness of things that you will see, and we will travel to hell so that you can tell the world that hell is real, the judgment is real and the satanic power is real. Those who reject my ways will fall to that frightening place called hell. There is more grace for the living to be saved, but there is no more chance for those who are dead. The Lord took my hand and said, we must now travel, and he took me to high mountain where there was two chairs. I saw that the Lord was wearing a white garment and a golden belt having the inscription of King of King and Lord of Lord. On his crown it was written the Lord Jesus Christ. His body was transparent and golden. I could see him in all dimension. The Lord was not white or black but golden and shining. There was blood in the holes of his hand. The Lord showed me the earth that was in darkness. He asked me, my son, what are you seeing? I said, I am not seeing anything. Then he pulled a white stone from his garment and put it on my eyes. It was then I was able to see the nation of the world. I saw men and animal. I saw the mind of men and heart of men. I saw many people going to the cemetery to bury their loved one, but I saw the souls of their loved one above the coffin following them. These people that were dead were trying to talk to their loved one, in order to tell them they are alive, but they could not enter in communication. Among the souls of men that were dead and wandering the earth, I saw a man that had died on the earth. I saw that this man had chains all over his body. There were chains on his neck, leg and feet, and I saw people that were dressed in black. These people were dragging this man that was bound in chains like a dog. I said, Lord, why are these men dragging this individual like an animal? I asked Jesus, are you seeing what is happening to that man? The Lord said, this man was wicked in his life and he never gave back to people what he owed them. When he died, he was chained and dragged by these demons of death. Then the Lord took me in the past to show me a traffic accident that had happened in our city. I saw a bus moving on the boulevard. As the bus was moving, I saw an angel of death. He was dressed in black, and he pushed the bus that was moving in the boulevard. As a result, this bus collided with another car and there was an accident. When I saw this accident, I said, Lord, I watched this accident in the past in the national television. The Lord said, my son, I brought you back in the past so that you can see what happened on that day of accident. When this accident happened, I saw the souls of the dead around this bus complaining about their death. These people had the shape of their body that had received shock in the accident. They had the shape of their body that were torn because of the accident. Jesus said, these people did not give their lives to God. That is why they are complaining. You gonna tell the people of the world that there are only two universes after death, which is hell and the paradise of God. These are the destination of the people. The Lord said, on the earth the wicked and the saint live together, but after death the wicked will be led to the abode of the dead and the saint will dwell in the paradise of God. There is no middle ground. When the souls of the dead were watching their body in this accident, I saw an infernal vehicle of hell with 12 unclean spirits inside. The demon who were inside this vehicle of hell were dressed in grey, and they had black crowns. I saw that they had pot of blood with them. Inside this vehicle I could hear secular music of the earth playing. I heard the leader of these demon ordering them to collect human blood in their pot and to capture the souls of these people that were dead. This demons came from a world of Satan that function with human blood, and wherever human blood was spilled on the earth they come to collect it. When they collect human blood, people lives get shortened. These demon often travel to different hospital to collect blood, for hospital is a place of blood supply. This vehicle was releasing a diabolic and cursed energy. When the infernal vehicle landed in the site of the accident, I saw these demon with their pot collecting human blood that was spilled in this bus. They took some souls and left others' souls. The Lord said, those who are left by these demon are people that had died before the time set by God. Those who died in the will of God as planned were taken to the abode of the dead. When people die before their time, they will wander the earth until they reach the time set by God. This is why there are so many wandering spirits on the earth. They cannot go to the abode of the dead until they reach the numbers of years that God gave them. The Lord previously said that there is five major kingdoms of Satan. The first is the kingdom ruled by the code 333, which is the dimension of maliciousness, jealousy, rancor and evil-hearted. This is the kingdom of which, there are people who have a bad heart. They don't like their friend to prosper, they reject their friend promotion, they feel pain when other people break through, they envy other people position. These people have the mark 333 on their forehead, because they are influenced by demons of wickedness and evil heart of the 333 kingdom. When these people that have the mark 333 died, they will go to hell and will be captured by demons of 333 kingdom. There is also the 555 kingdom that fabricate the plate 555. These property of Satan give demons legality. This kingdom of Satan is for household items and food, for they control the food, clothes and appliance we use on the earth. Most of food people eat in the world are not food. Often company sign packed with demon who multiplied food that they produced, so that they can supply the world with their food. These demons of 555 kingdom go to the cemetery and collect the bodies of deads, and they transform them to canned meat and processed meat that we eat. These production happen from September to February. They turned human part to chicken. People who sell food and clothes sign covenant with demons the 333 kingdom, because they deal with food. The other kingdom of Satan is the one ruled by the code 666 that deal with world system, the trend and pleasure of this world. The second beast required all people small and great. rich and poor, free and slave, to receive a mark 666 on their right hand or on their forehead, so that no one could buy or sell unless he had the mark 666. The other kingdom of Satan is the 777 kingdom, that is the kingdom of domination and power. Most politician works with demon of this kingdom, even pastors that aspire to have big church and crowds. There is also the kingdom of Satan of the code 999. This is the kingdom that deal with invention and technology, such as Apple, Android, new media. I remember when the Lord took me to the world of Satan, I saw plasma TV. The Lord said this technology of plasma TV was used in the world of Satan 3,000 years ago. It is because it is outdated that they sent it. It is because it is outdated that they sent it to the earth. Whatever technology humanity is using today was in trend in the world of Satan 100 of years ago, brother.